Yeah, we're at the track covering the Sport of Kings. Coming up, Dane Dawkins celebrates his first Jockeys Championship title with a rich Ian Levy Cup win aboard the top-rated Mahogany at Jamaica's Caymanas Park in Barbados. The St. Lucian apprentice Aaron Daniel aces the New Year's Day trophy event with a four-year-old filly, Mikal. We flash back to TNT's Boxing Day card, a massive two-year-old win for the 1-5 favorite Hello World. Plus, in the USA, stakes wins for Caribbean trainers Safi Joseph Jr. and Charlton Baker. Let's kick things off in Jamaica. And straight to the $4 million Ian Levy Cup. Eight horses going 8.5 furlongs. The field includes recent Moutet Mile winner Excessive Force and top-rated Gold Cup winner Mahogany, who is here in second. Down the backstretch, taking the title-chasing jockey Dane Dawkins toward the lead. Watched in the come box by Bran Rickman OD.
I've got Magic Attempts to go all the way. Mahogany stalking two lengths back in second. Excessive Force is the one racing down against the rail. Jordan Reigns attached to his outside. Calculus now sneaking closer. Miniature Man is six or seven lengths off that lead. A gap of some three to Prince Marshall, and El Professor remains at the back as the tempo has increased and they lead the 7/16th. I've got Magic tested now by the burly Mahogany. A half a length separates them. Jordan Reigns creeping closer along with Excessive Force getting the rail run. Calculus is under the pump needing to find six or more lengths in behind those and making ground. That's Prince Marshall, Miniature Man and El Professor at the back, but the field of turn for home in the Ian Levy. I've got Magic has his hands full. Mahogany now coming with a run. Here is Jordan Reigns out three wide as they charge up now toward the final furlong. It is Mahogany from Jordan Reigns. I've got Magic. Excessive Force now asked to get rolling, but Mahogany has them off their legs inside the final 16th. It is Mahogany coming away under Dane Dawkins. He'll have his second win and seal the Jockeys Championship. Jordan Reigns is next ahead of Excessive Force, and I've got Magic.
A fabulous win there for Mahogany, his fifth from eight starts in 2022, and very importantly, putting the icing on the cake for new champion jockey Dane Dawkins, fending off rival Anthony Thomas in the title race and making Mahogany's trainer Ian Passard look like a prophet. You may remember these comments over 2 years ago in the face of heavy criticism for Dawkins over his seemingly hasty 2,000 guineas ride when Mahogany lost to Wow Wow, August 2020. Passard taking some heat off the rider.
A lot of folks have been discussing about the ride. I think Dane Dawkins, first of all, is very professional. Dane Dawkins, in my view, is one of the top five riders at Caymanas Park. I think in future, Dane Dawkins has a lot of races to win. I predict he will be a champion jockey, and I predict he will win classic races as well.
Right on the money, Ian, because Dawkins has won classics as well since. A 14th lifetime win this for Mahogany as the even money favourite, scoring by a whopping five lengths in the Ian Levy over stablemate Jordan Reigns in a 1-2 finish for trainer Ian Passard. 1 minute 44 and 1/5 for the 8.5 furlong run. Three wins on the day for Dawkins, putting the lid on a season in which he registered as many as 8 4-timers. And pretty much held the upper hand in the Jockeys title race when it mattered most. He had entered the final day in pole position, 4 in front, finishing on 103 wins to be champion for the first time. 5 ahead of defending title holder Anthony Thomas, Tevin Foster a distant third on 49 wins, Rayan Lewis and 2-time champ Shane Ellis completing the top 5. And when the 2023 season kicked off on Tuesday, the new champion trainer Jason DaCosta celebrated his first trainer's title success with the SVREL Fan Appreciation Day trophy win. Under a skillful ride from 6-time champion jockey Omar Walker, DaCosta's 5-year-old mare Lure of Lucy made it gate to wire.
Coming to the furlong pole, it's Lure of Lucy, Positive ID trying to get to Lure of Lucy, but Lure of Lucy keeps on rolling. Positive ID still trying, Lure of Lucy from pillar to post, Lure of Lucy.
Kevin Burnside on commentary, Elizabeth DaCosta's Lure of Lucy by 3.5 lengths as a 6-5 favorite in the SVREL Fan Appreciation Day trophy race over the chasing 2-1 bet Positive ID. 156 they went for 9 furlongs and 25 yards. To the Garrison Savannah now, where the Barbados Turf Club opened its 2023 season on Monday with a New Year's Day handicap over 10 furlongs as the main event. 6 West Indies bred 3-year-old and older horses. New champion rider Tishon Hazelwood linking up with champion trainer Robert Pierce with a favorite Tudor Rose. But the 5-year-old mare is only third here as Dean Springer watches her stablemate Mikal take control.
as they turn towards the judge. And Mikal has come to the front. Rainbow Warriors hanging tough. Pavilion Warriors gets a lovely run on the inside. Waiter out, here it comes. I am safe with a round run as well. And Tudor Rose staying on at one pace. But it's Mikal who's going to get home, opening up to him by two or three. On the outside, Rainbow Warriors, best of the rest, will be second. Then came Tudor Rose.
First feature race win this for the St. Lucian apprentice Aaron Daniel, the 19-year-old younger brother of Eric Daniel. 7 wins now in his career as he steers a 4-year-old filly Mikal to a good victory that sets her up for a run in the big Tanglewood Stakes in March. Roundtable Stud Farms Mikal, a 27-1 runner-up in last year's Midsummer Classic, gets her third lifetime win in this New Year's Day trophy success at 7-2 odds over Rainbow Warrior, with the favourite Tudor Rose third. 2 1/4 lengths the victory margin, 2:22 3/5 the time for 10 furlongs for trainer Robert Pierce. A quick flashback now to Trinidad and Tobago's Boxing Day card, the St. James, St. Anne Stakes for 2-year-olds. And what a performance from the first time running colt, Hello World, watched in the Com Box by John Rupert.
Hello World has pulled away from Hearts Gap. Hello World opens up by about 3 lengths. Hearts Gap is in second spot. Then comes Angry Bird and Blinding Lights, who are also making some forward stride. But the colt is coming away from this field. And Hello World, the 1-5 favorite, is going to win the St. Anne St. James Stakes impressively.
On debut, Hello World champion jockey Brand Boodram sing aboard in the smashing victory for champion trainer John O'Brien, who was getting his third consecutive win in this event. After Super Bird and Crown Prince, the Poontip Stud Farms Hello World by 9 3/4 lengths in the St. James St. Anne Stakes as a big 1-5 favorite, clocking 124.12 for 6 3/4 furlongs.
Let's head up north now, where the Barbadian trainer Safid Joseph Jr. closed off a successful 2022 campaign with a win in the Harlan's Holiday Stakes at Gulfstream Park in Florida, where he won all the trainer's titles during the year.
Champion trainer at Gulfstream Park's early season championship meet, plus the spring-summer meet, and then the fall meet, 2022 triple champion Joseph sent out the favorite O'Connor in this $150,000 event. But it was the Barbadians Belmont Stakes third placer, Skippy Longstocking, with Irad Ortiz Jr. aboard in front. And traveling well coming off the final bend, the race call from Pete Aiello.
Less than 1/4 mile to go to the first finish line. Simplification given the green light to try to go get Skippy Longstocking, who made first run and has the lead. Back at the inside, Pioneer of Medina, not today for O'Connor. 1/8 mile to go. Skippy Longstocking still has the lead. Simplification is trying, but he's not making any ground. It's Skippy Longstocking to win it by 2 in the end.
A 3-1 bet in the 9th furlong grade 3 event. Skippy Longstocking scores by 2 lengths, clocking 142.76 for the 9th furlong Harlan's Holiday Stakes. The 4-year-old colt will now target the $3 million Pegasus World Cup Invitational at Gulfstream Park on the 28th of January. 19 stakes wins this on the season for Joseph, who finished the 2022 campaign as number 11 in North America's trainer standings with 174 wins and horses' earnings of a personal best, $10.15 million.
Jamaican trainer Charlton Baker also had some added money success with a win in the weekend's Gin Talkin' Stakes for 2-year-old fillies at Laurel Park in Maryland.
Baker's undefeated Malibu Moonshine, the 2-1 favorite, was kept off the early pace with Anhil Cruz aboard in the pink cap on the rail. She was actually second from last coming off the final bend, and after finding that clear rail run, would not be denied.
Here comes Malibu Moonshine down to the inside. Stonewall Star, Malibu Moonshine opening on the inside. Malibu Moonshine to scoot on through. Stonewall Star, Jamie Rodriguez trying to stay on. Here's Malibu Moonshine. Malibu Moonshine slips through with Angel Cruz to win. Photo for second, Jimmy Kisses and Stonewall Star.
I wasn't worried about it. I knew she was going to break slow. That's what Charlton Baker told me. He said, you know, she's slow from the gate, but when you break, just sit there patiently and wait for your move.
Charlton Baker knows his horse. Malibu Moonshine 3-0 now from 3 starts, topping Give Me Kisses and Stonewall Star for the Gin Talkin' Stakes as the 2-1 favorite, clocking 126.86 for the 7 furlong run in a 3/4 length win.
We've been at the track covering top stories and exciting races in the sport of kings. Check us out again next week.